name of the topic soil. Already you have studied in your previous class, you know what is the meaning of soil and importance of soil. So in this section we will discuss about soil, just you recall in our the previous class, isn't it? So soil is a one of the important natural resources. So it is one of the natural resources. Soil is one of the natural resources. The soil is very very important for in our life, isn't it? Because that all living organism it can survive on the soil surface only. Without soil we never get food from plants. Without soil cannot survive an animal on that earth surface. So the soil is very important for all living organisms. So the soil provides more nutrients and water plants. So the soil provide, you know, the soil provide water and minerals. The soil provide water and minerals to the plants. For the growing plants, the two things is very important: water and minerals. So these two things is very important. So the plants rarely get the two things, get from only that soil. So the soil is provided both water and nutrients to the soil, to the plants. Okay, and another one important thing that it is a home for all living organisms. Okay, what? The soil is a home for the all living organisms. So that many of the living organisms, you know, that many of the living organisms it can survive in the soil. So this way the soil is a home for all living organisms. Home for all living organisms. Okay. So the even the small insect to up to the multicellular organism itself, it can live in the soil surface. Okay, ma'am. And next one, so the soil is very important for agriculture. Okay, what? It is very useful for the agriculture purpose. The soil can be useful for the agriculture purpose. Without agriculture, we can't get food from the soil surface. Okay, what? Without soil, we never do the any agriculture. Okay? So the soil also is one of the essential for the agriculture. Okay, ma'am. So agriculture provide food, you know, that agriculture provide. That agriculture provide food and job and shelter. So that agriculture provide. Without soil, we can't do agriculture. The agriculture provides for us. What are the provide agriculture for us? Food, clothes, and shelter. Food, clothes, and shelter. So these are the three things is very important for all living organisms. You see, it's very important for all living organisms. What are the three things is very important for all living organisms? Food, clothes, and shelter. So these are the three things is very important for the agriculture. Okay, well, these are food, clothes, and shelter. So it is very important for us human beings. And it is inseparable in our life. So the soil is inseparable in our life. You know what is the meaning of inseparable in our life? Without soil, the living organism is called stable in our life on the surface. So that is the meaning of the inseparable in our life. Inseparable in our life. So the soil is a very important for in our life. Have you understood? And next one, the soil breathing with life. The next subtopic, the soil.
Have you understood? And we can use
the hand lens. We can use the hand lens and observe that soil. What you see? Observe that soil. What you see? Discuss with your friends and your class teacher. So definitely we have seen some different microorganisms in that soil. So first, what you see? First, you have seen that different microorganisms or different organisms it can live in that soil. So regarding to activity, what you know? The living organism it can survive in that soil. So that is the concept of this activity. Okay. And next one, the table, the 9.1, you know, the soil source. You know where you get the soil? First you get the soil from garden soil, then you collect the soil from roadside, and then you collect the soil from constructed areas. You know, so plants and animals or any other observation. So what kind of plants you can see in that roadside soil? Have you got it? And what kind of animals can live in that garden soil? And if you observe any other organism or any particle, it can survive on the soil. If S means that will the last part. Okay, well, do this activity. And then next one, already I told the soil is a very important in our life, you know. The some substances is always pollute the soil. Some substance is always pollute the soil. Already you know the main is or daughter. Mainly the first one, the polythene and plastics. The polythene bag and plastic is always can pollute the soil. Because for that two things is product from the, some chemicals. Okay, well. So the plastic and polythene bag. Okay, well, the plastics and polythene bag also it can pollute the soil. So these things it can pollute the soil. Polythene bags and plastics is always pollute the soil. So what do these kinds of plastics and polythene bags? You know, the some organism is naturally living that soil, you know. So this whenever we can use the polythene bag and plastics, then these things it can kill that microorganism in that soil. Some microorganism is harmful as we give up. So whenever we can use the two things like that polythene bag and the plastic, so these things will kill that microorganisms in that soil. So that way we can ban the plastics and polythene bags. So that way the government announced, you know, so we cannot use the plastic bag and polythene. It is a very harmful for us. What they are doing, these two things, the things is kill that microorganism in that soil. So it is not good for us. So that's why the government banned this thing for it. And some other substance also you can put in this soil. What are the substances? Like some the waste product, some the waste product and chemicals, waste product and chemicals and pesticides. So these are the things also it can pollute the soil. Okay, well. So how do you prevent this waste water and chemicals and pesticides? How do you control? Because the waste product is gone. So after recycling process only, after the recycling process only should be reached in the soil. And chemicals, you know, the chemicals should be treated. The chemicals, you know, these chemicals should be treated and released the soil. That means what? Why we are doing that thing? Because some chemicals absorb. Whenever we can treat the chemical substance, so during that process, some of the toxic substance it can absorb. The remaining some that waste pod or waste substance only can release the soil. So that is not harmful to the soil, because already we will get the toxic substance from the soil. And pesticides, we give up. So minimize the usage of pesticides. You know, when we are using the pesticides during the agriculture, you know, some that unwanted plants grown on that agriculture area, you know, so that's why farmer what they are doing, they will add the pesticides. So the pesticides also, because there is a chemical substance, you know, so that pesticides also can pollute the quality of soil. So that's why what will happen, the automatically the soil will be polluted. How will you control the use of pesticides? We can use the minimize, you know, we can use of that minimize level of pesticides we can use for that agriculture. So that is a good for soil as well as good for pasture.